give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can. Come on, let him know. I give myself.
Praise the Lord. This is our first Wednesday in the month of March, and I know as we be taking the journey every Wednesday of this month, God shall be changing your level in the name of Jesus Christ. It is our month of exploits. Glory to God. It's our month of what?
Exploits.
And no exploit can be done without the word of God. Hallelujah. But the people that do know their God, they shall be strong and they shall do exploits. They shall do what? Exploits. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The only way to know God is only through His word. There is no shortcut to it. If you don't know what the word of God says concerning your God, then you are void of exploits. You are void of what? Of exploits. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us bow our heads as we pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, this is yet another Wednesday Sunday service. Jehovah God, we pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Let this midweek service communicate to us, Father, your will concerning this month in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, change our level. Cause us to understand what you are saying in this hour. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we are gathered in your presence, not to reduce us, but to increase us. Father God, receive all the glory. We are grateful for your preservation. We are grateful for your blessings. And we are grateful for making us able to see the benefit of this day. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for your mercies. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your favor. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
Please be seated in the presence of God. Every Wednesday we shall be looking into a topic called exploring the treasures in the Word of God. Exploring the treasures in the Word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That shall be the theme of every Wednesday of this month of March as we gather in Jesus' mighty name. Glory to God.
Amen.
Exploring the treasures in the Word of God. So you must understand that the Word of God is loaded with treasures. So loaded with the what?
Treasures.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God's word is full of treasures. So the discovery of those treasures is what you shall be looking every Wednesday in these midweek services in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
So what is a treasure? A treasure can be mean a high valued asset. A highly valued asset. Hallelujah.
Amen.
A highly what? Valued asset. Glory to God. When you display a copper on the road, and at the same time you display diamond on the road. Hallelujah. The one who understands the treasures, the copper will be left, but that one of high value will be gone. Hallelujah. Treasure. Treasure is something which is of a very high value. Very high what?
Value.
Value. Hallelujah. So we shall be looking those values, those treasures which are loaded inside the Word of God. Which are what? Loaded inside the Word of God. Hallelujah. And discovering of those treasures is whereby we shall be engaging and taking advantage of those treasures in Jesus' mighty name. Let us go to the book of Matthew chapter number 13 and verse 44 and up to 45. The Bible says, the kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hidden in the field. The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hidden in the field. When a man finds it, he hid it. Again, then his joy went and sold all he had and brought that field. Hallelujah. So he said, the kingdom of God is like a treasure hidden inside the field. It's hidden where? Not exposed. It is hidden inside the field. So the field represents the Word of God. Represent what?
The Word of God.
And the field. The field. That field represents the Word of God. But those who see the Word of God as natural thing, they don't understand what is hidden inside the Word. So they ignore the Word. They do what? They ignore the Word. Many people have been living in Turkana. They have been saying, ah, that's a bogus place. But now there is treasure hidden in that field. There's what? Treasure. They have discovered oil. Another day they say they discovered underground water which can feed this nation for another 30 years. Tell me about those are treasures.
Those are treasures.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Treasures which are hidden inside the world. Inside the world?
The world.
So the man can sacrifice everything and buy that field. And do what? And buy the field. So this man who has found the field, he is ready to give up all. He said to do what? To give up all. Glory to God. So this man is willing to sell everything and buy that field. And do what? And buy that field. Why? Because there is treasure in that field. So every statement of scripture, there is a divine treasure inside of it. Every statement of scripture, there is a divine treasure inside of it. Every statement of scripture, there is a divine treasure inside of it. Glory to God.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
So, anytime you look to this book called Bible, inside that book lies great valuable or valuable or valuable precious. Valuable what?
Precious.
Inside this book. Let us go to the book of Isaiah, chapter 34. And verse 16. The Word of God is full of what? Treasures. Treasures. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So discovering of those treasures is what you make you to do exploits in the name of Jesus Christ. We are looking at verse number 16. It says, look into the scroll of the law and read. And do what? And read. None of these shall be missing. Not one shall lack on it. For it is his mouth that has given the order, and his spirit will gather them together. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
So we are told that look unto the Bible. Do what? Look unto it. It is looking inside the Bible that you find the treasure. It is looking inside the Bible that do what? Find the treasure. He said, look in the scroll that is the Bible, and read. And do what? And read. None of these shall be missing. So it's telling you, whatever you see in that book will not miss in your life. Whatever is missing in your life, as you look in that book, you'll find treasure that is missing in your life. So there is something which is missing in your life that you need to locate it in that book, in that field. Hallelujah. The Bible is a field that you need to look unto it to find the treasure that is missing in your life. Hallelujah. When you find it, you shall not miss it again. You shall not do what? Miss it again. Glory to God. Ezekiel chapter number 2. Ezekiel chapter number 2. And verse number 2. The Bible says, as he spoke, the Spirit came unto me and raised me to my feet, and I heard him speaking to me. So, when God speaks through the Bible you are reading, what you are going to hear is called the truth. Revelation of the truth. Revelation of what? When you are reading the Bible, there is another voice that's speaking to you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that's called what? The revelation of the truth. The revelation of what? When that revelation of the truth comes, it's aligned you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It aligns you to put to work what you have discovered. Hallelujah. When he spoke to him, the Spirit of God did what? Entered. The grace to align yourself to what is written comes upon you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To make you to put to work, to align yourself by what is written. Glory to God.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
So, what you have found is what you will always apply. What you always find in this book is what you will always apply. What you will find in this book is what you are going to apply. Glory to God. So, give holy to the word of God in this month of March, and apply yourself to the things which you are going to discover in that book. And I see you beginning to do exploits in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
So, let us look one of the treasures which is hidden in the word of God. One of the treasures called the treasures of wisdom. Treasure of what?
Wisdom.
The treasure of what?
Wisdom.
Of wisdom. The treasure of wisdom. So, in this book called the Bible, is hidden all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. Treasures of what? Wisdom and what?
Knowledge.
And knowledge. The Bible you are carrying, you are literally carrying the wisdom and the knowledge of God in a written form. In a what?
In a written
form. The Bible you are carrying is the source of wisdom. Glory to God. It is the ultimate source of God's wisdom. Is it what? Ultimate source of God's wisdom. So anytime you ignore the Bible, you are ignoring the wisdom of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us see what Jesus said in the book of Luke chapter 11 and verse number 49. Luke chapter 11 and verse number 49. The Bible says, Because of this, God in his wisdom said, I will send them prophets and apostles, some of whom they will kill, and others they will be persecuted. Therefore, this generation will be held responsible for the blood of all the prophets, and that has been shed since the beginning of the world, from the blood of Abel to the blood of Zechariah, who was killed in the altar on the sanctuary. Yes, I tell you, this generation will be held responsible of it all. So Jesus called scriptures wisdom, because it what? He said from Abel. So where do you discover that wisdom? It's only in the book. He said from Abel to Zechariah. And Jesus called that is wisdom of God. Because it's what? The wisdom of God. Hallelujah. He said, because of this, God in his wisdom. So now Jesus continued to explain where this wisdom is coming from. He said from Genesis, from the beginning. They killed Abel, Cain killed other prophets like this, even to the one who died on the altar, on the sanctuary. This generation shall be called that blood. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So, Jesus called scriptures the wisdom of God. He calls the scriptures what? Wisdom of God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians chapter number 1 and verse 24. 1 Corinthians chapter number 1 and verse number 24. The Bible says like this. But to those whom God has called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. He said Christ is what? The power and also what? The wisdom of what? Of God. Hallelujah. John chapter 1. I want to connect that scripture with John chapter 1. John chapter 1. John chapter 1 from verse 1, say like this. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And verse 2, he was with God in the beginning, verse 3, through him all things were made, without him nothing was made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shined darkness, but the darkness has could not understand it. Let us look at verse number 14. And the Word became flesh and dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the One, the only who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. So he said, Jesus Christ, who is the Word of God. So when you connect those scriptures with that scripture we read in 1 Corinthians chapter 1 from verse 2, it says, Christ, the power of God, and the wisdom of God. That tells you the Word of God.